This is more than just a new 100 amp hour, 12 volt battery from Renogy. It is a completely new technology and it's gonna be a game changer. Welcome back to the channel, guys. This is the Renogy Rego Super Slim Solid State Lithium Battery, and it is completely different from any other battery that they offer on their market. Before we get into the details on this battery, I wanted to tell you guys the deal with Solid State. Solid State is a lithium battery, but it is solid state. So there are no liquid electrolytes inside the battery. And unfortunately, solid state batteries actually aren't mass produced yet, but what is hitting the market is these semi-solid state batteries. Even though they're calling this a solid state battery, it's actually a semi-solid state battery and it has 70% less liquid than your standard lithium iron phosphate battery. Now there are three big pros to solid state batteries. One being they have a higher energy density, two, they have a higher thermal stability, and three, they're actually safer because they're puncture resistant, which means they have a far less likelihood of catching on fire. The fact that this battery has a higher energy density means that you can charge it at up to 100 amps and discharge it up to 200 amps. This battery is also good up to 6,000 cycles at 80% DOD, and Renogy is backing it by an 8-year warranty. The higher thermal stability, because there is less liquid in this, means that you can charge it down to negative 10 degrees Celsius, which is really impressive. Do you even need a heated battery anymore? We definitely do, because it gets below minus 10 all the time here in Canada. But for people who live in the States and don't do a lot of traveling in the winter, this is going to be perfect. Be sure to use the discount code Made to Travel if you're purchasing anything from Renogy, including this battery, and you'll get an extra discount on those solar components when you go to checkout. You can easily mount this behind car seats for overlanding rigs. There are mounting screws on both sides here, and Renogy does sell brackets. You can actually mount multiple of these batteries together and stream them in series or parallel as well. So you could have a 24 volt system or a 48 volt system, and they simply just sandwich together. Now, as far as weight goes, this battery weighs 26.2 pounds versus say Renogy's Pro model 100 amp hour battery, which comes in at 26.9 pounds. This battery is super heavy duty. It has a full metal case around it. In the box, you're gonna get two sets of mounting bolts for the positive and the negative terminals here, and then you're also gonna get caps, and these are actually pretty cool. They slide over top and click into place, and then you can rotate them or spin them around whichever way your cables end up running. In the middle here is the Bluetooth antenna, so you can hook this up to the Renogy DC home app, and then on either side of the Bluetooth antenna, you're gonna have an up port and a link port, and those are gonna be connecting multiple batteries or other Renogy components like the Renogy One Core. The new battery sitting right here, and then I got my current setup right over here. This inverter charger is honestly working phenomenally. We've been testing it out for like 6 months to a year now, and it has been working great. And then got the 400 amp hour Rego, which has also been working awesome. No problems there. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this massive battery out, and we are gonna be installing this and testing it out to see how it performs. Got the battery all connected here. Ideally, you would run your positive connection to an on-off switch and then to your positive bus bar. I don't have an on-off switch because my Rego has a power button here. So I basically just turn it on and off whenever I want to disconnect it. My negative runs up and to the shunt, which is connected to my Renogy 500 amp battery monitor. And that is it for the installation. I am using 4-aught gauge wire. I'll link it below in the description. If you want to pick some of this up, you can buy it on Amazon, or if you want to get it cheaper, you can run down to your local welding shop. That is honestly the cheapest option for large gauge wire like this. Next up is actually connecting it to your phone, which is really easy to do. I've already connected it. I'll show you how to do it right now. You basically hit the plus icon, tap all the products that you want to add, and then you have all these parameters that you can check out. I've also turned on my inverter charger, and we can go to that. And the cool thing about this inverter charger is I can actually change how much charge amps we are putting into the battery. So right now it's set for 100. That's the max that this battery can handle. So let's hit it with 100 and see what happens. So I hit it with 100 amps, but I forgot my solar was still turned on here.
and we got a charge overcurrent warning right away. So that's really nice. The BMS is working as it should. Let's go ahead. I'm just gonna shut off my solar. We're getting about 98 amps into the battery, no problem. As soon as I trigger that solar, you get a warning, which is honestly really nice. I'll turn it back on here and let's see. Oh yeah, overcharge warning. That is perfect. So the BMS is working as it should. Now let's go ahead and put a load on this. We can do up to 200 amps, and I'm capable of doing that with this 3000 watt inverter charger. So let's go ahead and see what happens. I hooked up this little space heater, pulls about 1500 watts, and we're currently discharging at almost 140 amps. I got a power station charging in the front of the van, and it is pulling about 107 amps. So let's turn this heater up a little bit and see what happens. 188.5. Whew. Seems to be working awesome though so far. We have 15 minutes remaining. That's not long at all. I guess that's what happens when you're drawing almost 200 amps from a 12 volt battery. It's only 100 amps. Jeez, that is working awesome. I know a lot of people complain about some of Renogy's Bluetooth stuff, so let's go ahead and do a little Bluetooth test. To be honest, my 400 amp hour Rego doesn't work all that well with Bluetooth. It doesn't go very far. So let's shut these doors and I'll just start walking away from the van and see how far we can get. Standing outside the van, still got a signal. Well, that's actually pretty good. Oh, disconnected. So I'm probably about 20, maybe 15, 20 feet from the van, lost connection. Let's go back and see. Oh, reconnected. Not bad, honestly. Being inside the van, there's insulation, there's a whole bunch of stuff in the way. So it's definitely better than my Rego. I can be standing right next to the van and not have a connection sometimes.
These are also the brackets that you can buy with the battery. They can mount to the wall. And then if you're buying multiple batteries, there's another bracket that you can buy that extends out so you can attach multiple batteries, which is awesome. These seem super solid.
One last thing I wanted to show you guys. Me and Kaylee picked up a Tacoma a few years ago and have seriously been debating getting a rooftop camper for it and stuff. Not quite yet, but with this battery, it actually fits. You would not believe this. Behind the seat. You could have like your setup here. You could put it underneath the front seats if you wanted to. This thing would just fit anywhere. Like I can just go ahead, close that up. You could honestly fit majority of your solar components back here without a problem at all. If you need a slim design, this battery is the best battery to get, no doubt. But if you don't need a slim battery, and when you're talking volume, the 100 amp hour 12 volt mini from Renogy is actually smaller in volume. This battery is just a lot more durable. So if you're looking for something cheaper and space isn't a big deal, I would probably go with the mini or the pro even. But there's also the perks of the longer lifespan, higher cycles, and you can charge it at negative 10, which is pretty cool.
Now, the one downside of this battery is it actually comes in at a price tag of $750, which is definitely on the higher end. Be sure to use the discount code Made to Travel if you're purchasing anything from Renogy, including this battery, and you'll get an extra discount on those solar components when you go to checkout. I have developed a complete solar system guide that covers everything from components to parts list to schematics. I'll link it below in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions about this battery or other Renogy components, be sure to comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. See you in the next one.